Did you win the penis lottery or lose it? Today I'm revealing the 5 factors that determine your size. Some of them before you were even born. Some might surprise you. Let's dive in. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. Speaking of, your penis size, not a copy of your dad's. You get it from your mom. Crazy? Then watch this. Lucky number 1, your mom's genetic gift. Men get something called the X chromosome from mother only. This carries the blueprint for penis development. Think of it like a recipe card. This recipe controls how your body responds to testosterone. Your mom's recipe card has special sections called CAG repeats. More repeats mean your body ignores testosterone signals. Less response equals smaller size potential. Your mother's DNA determines this completely. Dad gives you maleness through the Y chromosome, but size sensitivity, that's all mom's genetics. Luck of the draw, some guys inherit weak testosterone responses. Their bodies don't listen to growth signals well. Others get strong responses and better development. This genetic coin flip happened at conception. You can't change these inherited instructions, but understanding them explains everything. If you find this information interesting and you want more, subscribe so you never miss out, especially when activating the bell. And in case you want this information in writing, sign up for my newsletter, link in the description. Okay, let's continue with what happened with you before you were born. Lucky number 2, life in mom's belly. Your penis had a make or break time period, weeks 8 to 14 inside mom. Scientists call this the masculinization programming window. Think of it as construction season. During these weeks, everything your mom did mattered. Her diet, her health, even her stress levels. The placenta worked like a delivery system. It brought hormones and nutrients for construction. A 2013 study looked at newborn Mexican babies. When moms were exposed to plastic chemicals, babies had smaller penises. Poor nutrition during pregnancy stunted development completely. Problems with the placenta caused lasting damage. Even moms smoking cigarettes affected hormone levels. Doctors measure something called anogenital distance in babies. This predicts adult penis size accurately. This measurement never changes throughout life. Toxic chemicals in the environment disrupted normal development. These hormone disruptors changed construction plans forever. Your final size was mostly decided before you took your first breath outside. Lucky number 3, the environment switch. There's something called epigenetics that's like dimmer switches. They turn genes up or down. This happened before you were born. Your mother's diet affected these genetic switches. Poor eating disrupted normal gene activation. Missing vitamins like folate messed up the system. A 2022 study showed mom's health changes which genes turn on. These changes can affect your kids too. Think of genes like light bulbs. These switches control which ones shine bright. During early pregnancy, all switches get reset. Mom's stress hormones affected this process. Her vitamin levels were incredibly important. Even your grandmother's health influenced your development. These switches determine if good genes actually work. Healthy moms optimized gene performance. Sick or stressed moms suppressed growth genes. This programming happened during vulnerable baby-making time. Once set, these switches rarely flip again. Some switch changes pass to your children. Your mother's pregnancy affected your son's development. This explains why penis size runs in families. Genes load the gun. These switches pull the trigger. Lucky number 4, the teenage growth explosion. Puberty was your last chance to grow. Testosterone and growth hormones exploded together. This determined your final adult size. A 2021 study by Dr. Pastuzak confirmed this pattern. Healthy teenage years unlock full genetic potential. Late puberty limits final growth completely. Poor nutrition during high school stunts development permanently. This is a serious point. I'll get to that in a minute. I'm talking about your lucky number 5. It's a hidden factor nobody talks about. Childhood obesity. But before we get there, let's not forget that serious illnesses interfere with hormone surges. Your testicles produced massive amounts of testosterone. Growth hormone peaked while you slept. These hormones woke up sleeping growth programs. Your penis reached its maximum genetic potential. This growth window slammed shut around age 18. Stress delayed puberty in many teenage boys. Junk food diets reduced hormone production significantly. Very early or very late puberty affected outcomes. But the underlying genetic programs stayed the same. Puberty simply activated what was already programmed. Once your growth plates fused together, development stopped forever. No food or workout changes this. Your adult size became permanently locked in. This explains why nothing works later. Now, as promised, lucky number 5, the childhood weight connection. Here's something most parents don't know. Childhood obesity directly stunts penis growth permanently. This isn't just about appearance anymore. Fat tissue in kids produces an enzyme called aromatase. This enzyme converts testosterone into estrogen. More fat equals more estrogen production. Higher estrogen levels block normal penis development. A study of over 1,000 boys confirmed this. Obese kids had 10% less penis growth. The timing matters enormously here. Pre-puberty obesity causes real size reduction in adults. Adult obesity only affects how big you look. One study tracked boys into adulthood specifically. Guys who were fat before puberty had permanently smaller penises. Guys who got fat later had normal penises. 80% of one doctor's obese boy patients had micropenis. That's not buried under fat tissue, that's actual underdevelopment from hormonal disruption. The fat tissue literally steals testosterone from developing genitals. This makes childhood weight control absolutely critical. Once puberty ends, the damage becomes permanent. No amount of adult weight loss fixes this. So you see, your penis size was locked in before birth. It was a lottery all along. Mom's genes, her pregnancy health, and genetic switches decided everything. Teenage hormones brought out this potential fully. Adult lifestyle changes how you look, not reality. Penis size is determined by many factors, and there are small differences around the globe. Want to know what they are? Then watch my Penis Around the World series here. It'll tell you a lot about that. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.